Hey, Freedom House, welcome back to Weekly Words. I hope you've been enjoying every single session we've been putting out to you. Our whole aim through this time is that you and I would go stronger with God. At the end of the day, we are meant to be disciples of Jesus, not just casual church attending Sunday Christians. God wants us to grow deeper with Him, and that's our aim over this time. To that end, we want to put some incredible material out there with you. And we have the incredible privilege of having Alexander Fenter in the house with us. He and Jill have joined the family over the past few months. And he has, if you've never met him before, or never heard of him before, has a long history of leading churches. He is closely connected with the Vineyard movement and has an incredible part to play there still. But equally so, he has written many books and still has many more to write. He is putting together a four-part series on prayer that during this time, as we lock down at home with our families, we go deep with Jesus in intimacy and develop our prayer life with Him. I hope you're going to enjoy this. I have no doubt that you will. God bless you, Freedom House, and let's grow strong with God.
Good morning. As Ryan has already mentioned, my name is Alexander Fenter, and I'm honored to be with you for the next 10 minutes or so to speak about four different modes or ways of prayer. So as from the previous talk on verbal prayer, I am working from a diagram in my book Doing Spirituality, whereby I summarize the four spiritual traditions in the history of the Christian church in terms of four different ways of praying. Verbal prayer, which is more the evangelical reformed tradition of spirituality. Then there is meditative prayer, which I'm going to deal with now, which is more the Catholic Orthodox tradition of prayer. Then there is contemplative prayer, which is more the mystical monastic tradition of prayer. Then the ecstatic form of prayer, which is more the Pentecostal charismatic style or mode of prayer. So again, just to emphasize the point, in this time of lockdown, because of the crisis that we're facing with the coronavirus, it's a God opportunity to practice solitude and silence, to be alone with God and cultivate and develop your relationship with God, as well as with the people in your home or close to you. Keep bodily distance, but relational solidarity. In this time of deepening our prayer life, we can practice meditative prayer, which goes beyond verbal prayer. So, but essentially, verbal prayer is talking aloud directly to God, which is an expression of our thoughts and our hearts to God. Meditative prayer is the movement from addressing God verbally to becoming more and more quiet to listen to God silently. Meditative prayer has to do with silence, but its content is still around the Word of God, but not exclusively God's Word. It's also meditating through symbols that God gives us in nature, through pictures, through what the Orthodox Church called icons, sacred art that depict the Trinity and other forms through which we can meditate on God. So the means of our meditation to listen to God and enter into a deeper form of prayer is primarily the Word of God. We meditate on it, but it's not exclusive to that. It's all forms of symbols and means that God gives us to meditate on as what we call a sacrament, a means of grace, a means of encountering the presence of God that leads us into engagement with God. So Jesus, once again, was a Jewish rabbi, young man, 30 years old. His life, His death, and especially His resurrection vindicated Him as the Messiah of Israel, the King of Israel, but not only Israel, of the whole world. And we are followers of that Messiah. We learn from Him. So Jesus practiced meditation. The Hebrew form of meditation actually is to mutter, to chew over God's word like a cow chews the cud. And it's essentially based, once again, in the book of Psalms, which is God's specific revelation of his inspired word to us, but also his general revelation of meditating on creation, through which God also reveals himself to us. So the Hebrew idea is that you read and pray the Psalms out aloud verbally, as I mentioned in my first teaching, but then you go beyond praying it out aloud, and you enter into silence, and you begin to cogitate on it in your mind. You think through the words of God, whether it's the Psalms that you are praying, or whether it's any form of scripture or passage of scripture anywhere in the Bible. You begin to think and meditate, and you mull it over in your mind, and you become silent and still, and through that you hear what God is saying to you. God speaks through his word. Mother Teresa has a definition of prayer that she always used to use. Prayer is listening to God in the silence of your heart. We are so used to verbal prayer that silence becomes difficult for most evangelical charismatics. But in my opinion, it's one of the biggest things we need to learn as evangelical charismatics is silence and solitude. Silence is practiced within solitude when you are alone with God. And you begin to become still and you begin to hear God speaking to you in your thoughts, through feelings in your body, through emotions that run through you, through pictures in your imagination. God communicates with us in the whole of the way he made us, through all of our faculties, not just through our minds. So meditation is engaging God actively through thoughts, words, pictures, symbols, as we think through and meditate and hear what the Lord is saying. Then we feed back to God what we hear him saying. And it leads us to pray and engage with God in this ongoing silent dialogue of listening and speaking. So it's conversation with God in your heart, in your mind, through meditation. That is what we call meditative prayer. So just to bring this into a bit of a framework from the Catholic and the Orthodox tradition that we as evangelicals can learn about. The Catholics as well as the Orthodox, but more so in the Latin Western tradition, they used what they called Lectio Divina in the Latin. Lectio Divina, Lectio means reading, Divina means divine. And they had four steps in terms of learning or teaching this meditative prayer. The first step is Lectio. You read God's word. And of course, primarily the Psalms, because they are prayers to God. So you read it and read it aloud while listening to God in the text. And as I said, of course, if you're reading through the Gospels, the stories of Jesus or Pauline epistles or the prophets, whatever passage you read, and you read aloud, listening to God to speak to you in the text. And often a phrase jumps out at you, or there's a thought that grabs you, or a picture arises in your mind as you're reading, but something makes sense somewhere as you're reading. Then you latch onto that, and you become silent and wait and listen to God. You then do, from Lectio, you go to Meditatio. Meditatio is a Latin word for meditation. You think about it, you mull it over, you chew it, you question God in your mind. What does this mean? What are you saying to me, Lord? Why did David say this now? That impresses me, but I don't understand it. Lord, tell me. And you begin to have this meditative conversation in your mind with God around what that text means. That overflows into the third step, oratio. Lectio, reading the text. Meditatio, mulling it over and conversing with God, listening to God for his word to you in the text. Oratio, the third step, is responding to God verbally by what he's saying to you. Then you start praying around it. It leads you to pray for people. It leads you to pray for all different things. And you go back into verbal prayer. And then the last and fourth step in Lectio Divina is contemplatio. Contemplatio is the Latin word for contemplation, which we're going to do in the next talk. Contemplation essentially is remaining in the afterglow of complete stillness with God, in intimate union with God that goes beyond words, pictures, and symbols into intuitive union with God. But I'll explain that more in our next talk. So just to go over that again, practice Lectio Divina. Take 20 minutes, even half an hour. If you can, take an hour. But enter the presence of God with a prayer of invitation for the Lord to be fully present and to engage with God. Read a text, do Lectio. Once you've read a passage of scripture, a psalm or whatever, have 10 minutes of silence, meditating on it in your heart and mind, conversing with God about it, listening to God, what He's saying to you through the text. You go back to the text and read, you think, you pray. Then you can pray verbally around what God has said to you and respond back to God what He is saying to you, which will lead you to pray and intercede for various things. That's verbal prayer, oratio. And then you have a time of 5-10 minutes in the afterglow, in the embrace and the arms of intimacy with your Father, with Abba, called contemplatio, contemplation, intuitive, intimate union with God, which we will talk further about. So lastly, in the Orthodox tradition, this meditative prayer has three movements as opposed to four movements in the Western tradition. So the three movements are essentially around what is called the prayer of the lips, the prayer of the mind, and then the prayer of the heart. And they have cultivated it through the monastic movement from the Desert Fathers and St. Anthony of the Desert, 300 AD, all the way through in the Eastern tradition of the monastic movement. It's what's called the Jesus Prayer. And the Jesus Prayer is, Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on me, a sinner. And they taught people how to pray that with your breathing in and out. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy on me, a sinner. And it begins with verbal prayer. Then it goes and it becomes just part of your thought life. And it starts working in your mind, as Paul says, pray continually, pray without ceasing. So the continual prayer, praying without ceasing, is this prayer of the mind, which is the prayer of silence, where you start engaging God, and in your mind you're listening, you're opening, you're dialoguing, you're conversing, and it becomes inward and transformative. And that eventually sinks from your mind into your heart. And the heart is this intuitive union with God that goes beyond thoughts, pictures, words, images in your mind. And it becomes this contemplation. So they have a similar thing to Lectio Divina, except that it's three steps. Prayer of the lips, which leads to prayer of the mind, which is practicing the silent meditation of listening to God and engaging with God, which eventually, if practiced long enough, subsides deep into the heart, which is an intuitive, indirect, or rather direct, union with God that goes beyond all words, all thoughts, all images, all sensations, into mystical oneness with the Lord by His Holy Spirit. And we'll develop that in our next talk. Why don't you take time and practice either Lectio Divina or even the Jesus Prayer? You can backtrack on this video, listen again to the Jesus Prayer, and begin to learn that and start praying that. Try to pray it continually, ceaselessly, verbally, and in your thoughts as much as you can through the day, and see what begins to happen in your heart. Thank you.